Hey, happy Monday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. And look right here in front of it. It's getting a lot of convection. That's what that blue is convection. You can see a lot of convection on the storms in front of this system. So all that's going to group together, and then it's going to start rapid intensifying again. They still have it going to a Cat 4. It did not show in the 5. Now, whether it's going from a 5 to a 4 or whether it stays 4, it doesn't matter. This is going to be in the Gulf. Also like to add on landfall. So on landfall, whether it's going to be a high-end Cat 3, right now it's showing that it's going to be somewhere towards 127 miles per hour, right on the edge of a Cat 4, but it's still showing that it's going to come in very strong. It's going to start hitting the brakes as it gets closer, and right before landfall, it's going to be somewhere right around a high-end Cat 3. Some models show it could be right on a low end of a 4, but still dramatically drop in intensity. By the time it gets to the middle of Florida, it's still going to be a hurricane, but it's 86 miles per hour sustained winds, which is bad enough, but it showed before that it could be 92. Unfortunately, we're seeing a lot of storm surge, 8 to 12 feet. Now, if you're in all of this pink area, even up here by the tropical storm, all this brown in the north, this brown to the south, this is tropical storm watch area. It will be warnings as we get a little bit closer. But the rest of this area, all the way inland, is all hurricane watch. This will turn into warning as you get closer. But this whole area right here is going to endure a lot of very strong winds. Now, it's still doing some wobbling. But you can see as it gets closer that we're literally down to just a few of these. It can still go southern. And it can still agree with this group and head further towards the north. Plus, as it's heading further to the towards the north, look at this. Right before landfall, when we're trying to figure out if this is going north or south on a wobble, it could still go towards Cape Coral. It could still head north towards Tampa or Sarasota. There are still many options on the table. So we're still not knowing which way this system is going to wobble. We still got to stay updated. Remember, I think this afternoon we should have a pretty good idea, but we still won't know until it finishes because it's going to keep wobbling. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. That way you know what to expect. Thank you to everyone that got the word out. Help hit that like button, share the video. Let people know what the impacts are and what is going on. Please keep that love going and do it again. Let people know what the updates are. Because literally, by the time we go into tomorrow, you are done with any kind of preparing for this system. As we go into Wednesday morning, you're going to start feeling tropical storm impacts already. I'd like to add that a lot of people are saying this is going to be a Cat 4 hurricane on landfall. Whether this is a Cat 3, whether it weakens down to a high-end Cat 2, you're still going to feel Cat 3 impacts as it's weakening down, so it's still going to be very powerful. Plus the storm surge, plus the tornadoes and everything else. Whether it's a high-end Cat 3, a low-end Cat 3, or a low-end Cat 4, it's going to be the same outcome. It's going to be devastating and catastrophic. Please leave. Latest intensity guidance is still taking the hurricane models well up into that Cat 5 status. A good chunk of them is showing to be anywhere between a Cat 4 to a Cat 3. While it's in its strengthening phase, that's what National Hurricane Center is going by as well. And you can see as it goes towards landfall, it is going to be either a low-end Cat 4 or it's going to be a low-end Cat 3, maybe even a high-end 2 right around landfall. So whether it's either one of these, it don't matter. It's going to be dangerous and very bad anyway. And it's predicted to slow down and hit the brakes pretty good, unfortunately, as it does landfall. So it's not going to stay a major hurricane across Florida. Those who have heard that, that is a lie. It's unbelievable how much false information has been coming out about this hurricane, and it's sad. But you can see for yourself whether it's a major hurricane Cat 3 or a 4. It is just going to be devastating and catastrophic. It is going to be bad regardless. Latest guidance is favoring that northward push. You can see right there. It could even go still above Tampa, below Tampa. And we're still seeing a possibility for the southern side. At least another 12 hours before we know exactly what's going on. We need to get right here before we get on that final approach, know which way this is majority going. Even if it takes away that southern side right here, and it just shows the northern side, we won't know that northern or southern of Tampa wobble until it gets closer. It's going to be very tight all the way until landfall. And this is why it's bad. It's just like Helene. This is why the storm surge and the rain event was so bad. It's such a big and broad system with the fast movement speed is what's bringing all this storm surge. Now they brought it up to anywhere from 5 to 10 feet on this little section right here. But once you get around Tampa and Southern, it starts going from 8 to 12 feet. Then it lowers back down from 5 to 10 by Charlotte Harbor. Then you also have the 4 to 7 to 2 to 4. You even got 1 to 3 for the Keys. And you got 1 to 3 over here for the Big Bend. You even have a section over here by Cedar Key for 3 to 5. And there will be some on the northeastern side. It will add some storm surge, especially over here around Jacksonville, for the onshore flow after the hurricane goes over Florida. Rainfall amounts did change as well. So you still got the 4 to 6 inches in all of this lighter yellow. You got 6 to 8 in a darker yellow. But over here from Jacksonville down towards Orlando, you got chances for 8 inches towards a foot. Plus storm surge. You also get strong over here by southern Florida and especially down here by the Florida Keys. The flooding has changed. So you do have the moderate level for flash flooding on the southern side and a huge section on the northern side, as well as all this going into southern Georgia and the tip over here for South Carolina. You can see for all the way until Tuesday, all the way till tomorrow morning, it starts adding up on southern Florida, going towards central Florida. But it really gets heavy as you go from Wednesday through Thursday on that rain event. That's when it starts passing over and you get that onshore banding. Now remember, I have this link in the description for you as well, so you can go zoom in and see what your potential worst case scenario is. All that red is above 9 feet, just so you can see where the bad areas are potentially of getting all this very huge storm surge. You can see it over here around the Tampa region. You can even see it further to the south if it does take that southern wobble, where all the bad storm surge could potentially be if it wobbles south or if it wobbles north. So please go use this so you can expect how much feet of water is actually your worst case scenario. Also, don't forget, as this comes onshore, not only with the dangerous storm surge, it's going to be very much damaging waves. So while you're getting anywhere from 8 to 12 feet storm surge, if it does head north, you're still going to be dealing with anywhere from 18 to 15 to 20 foot waves that's going to be crashing on top of that storm surge. So just keep that in mind. It's going to be very rough. If the eye is on the southern side, it will pull it out. If it's on the northern side, it will push it in. So remember that, and that's for both areas. And you can see down here also, anywhere from 10 to 15 foot waves. But look at this, as it comes in for Wednesday, late Wednesday, that's where you get your most severity, showing that you almost 20 foot waves is coming on shore. So please be aware of this. This is going to make it even worse on your impacts. Chances for tornadoes has gone up, of course. So as you go through for tomorrow, for Tuesday, they do have the beginning of the rain bands coming from the hurricane. So you have the marginal. So far, here's your cities at risk in Florida within a 25-mile area. Now, as you go into Wednesday, that's where it gets even stronger. So now you got the big slight risk kicking in, chances for your tornadoes, as well as the marginal going further north. So here's your cities at risk for Wednesday for your chances for your tornadoes. But you see also, as you go through Wednesday morning, that's where it starts getting hit with the shear. So as it goes through Wednesday towards landfall for Wednesday night, still showing this could potentially be a late night, maybe even a midnight landfall, everyone, where you won't be able to see. And you can see all the shear hitting that system. That will put it on the brakes going from a Cat 4 to a Cat 3 and potentially down to a Cat 2 right before landfall. But still, for 3 hours until it does weaken down and literally the eye gets on landfall, there will be some strong bands going around with these winds of the Cat 3 status. So keep that in mind. Just because they say, hey, it could go all the way down to a Cat 2 landfall, that don't mean don't leave. This is going to be horrible if it makes it in time to weaken down. If this storm system speeds up, it will be a Cat 3 landfall regardless. So whether it's a high end 2, a low end 4, this is going to be the same impacts. It's going to be horrible. Please leave. Showing is still trending that it'll get all the way up to that Cat 5 status with the hurricane models. These are the new models, everybody. Look, all the way to 180 miles per hour sustained winds, but still it weakens down. It gets that dry air, it gets that shear. Look how quickly it goes down from a 4 boom, it goes all the way down towards a 3. Then right before landfall, it drops down to a 2. But this is my point. The whole time, right before landfall, you have this big banding. Look at the winds. The winds are going all the way around. This is a huge wind field. It's not just this little piece right here. So you're going to feel the winds as it slowly goes 3 hours until it goes inland. Look at all the over 100 miles per hour sustained winds. Then for another 3 hours, while you're still getting it, now you're getting surge coming in from this section. Then after it crosses over, then you're going to start getting the surge and the winds coming into that direction, your onshore flow. So please do not downgrade this system, and don't even think about it even being upgraded. Anywhere from a strong 2 to a weak 4, you're going to have the same impacts. It's going to be devastating and catastrophic. This weather is going to be 10 or 15 miles per hour more winds is the difference, and that's not enough difference to even care. This is going to be bad, everybody. Showing the wind gusts will start spreading out as you go from Wednesday morning. You could feel the tropical storm force wind gusts along the west coast of Florida. As you're going through the afternoon, you're really going to feel it even further along the west coast of Florida. But as you go into the evening, this is where it starts kicking in the 70, the 80, the 90, even 140 almost around the center. And you can see it's still strongest on the western side. You still have it on the eastern side, but the western side is still strongest. And as it comes in for landfall around 10 p.m. towards midnight, you're still getting a very powerful wind. You're still getting banding going all the way up into Georgia, all the way around towards southern Florida. So keep that in mind. It's not just a small area. After it goes across over in the morning, next morning, by Thursday, as you go into the morning, here comes that onshore flow, the onshore winds, and the chance for the tornadoes. This will upgrade as well for storm surge and tornadoes for Thursday. Now, the show is trending. You can see on B, it's showing all the way up to 180. Like I said, it don't matter whether it's a 5 or a 4. It is going to weaken down all the way to a 4. Then it weakens down greatly down to a 3. Then it quickly weakens down to a 2 after that. See, that's what I was trying to tell you. It's going to still hit the brakes. It's going to weaken down right before landfall. Look, it even goes down to a high-end Cat 1 because literally your eye is not on shore yet. This is taking a little bit more of that northward pull. So if it shows a Cat 1 right here, don't let that fool you because you're still going to get Cat 3 and Cat 2 winds. Very powerful until this eye goes on land. That landfall Cat is just with the center of the eye. It's not all these huge impacts that you're going to feel for hours. Now, this is H-Wharf model. This is a third one to go by so you can see what the trends may be. This one takes it to where it barely even a Cat 4, but it weakens down quickly to a Cat 3. Then it goes down to a Cat 2 to a Cat 1 hurricane. A lot of shear hitting it. But remember, that jet stream is going to help pull it to the north, speed it up, and help it breathe. So it's going to be combating the shear as well. Goes back to a Cat 2 and starts strengthening a little bit as it goes back towards landfall and bringing it way further to the north, I would like to add. Look at that. And look at the H-mon, trying to show you all four of them, showing it will be that 4, but showing it will weaken down from the shear, and it weakens down greatly. Look at this. It intensifies back to a 4, then the very next step, 3 hours later, it is barely a 2 going on landfall. So that's what I'm trying to say. Even though it shows maybe a 2 on landfall, you're going to feel the impacts from a 3 and possibly a 4. And quick update on possible Nadine coming right afterwards, showing that we still might have that cold front coming down and still showing a weakening like we saw with the Euro update yesterday, that it could be a weaker system and get blocked right there and possibly have another cold front. This is still anywhere from 8 to 10 days from that happening. I'm still not showing the cold front in the data. I will keep you updated. And you can see this right here showing with the Euro that it might have another dip coming through of a cold front. It might be a lower down trough on the eastern side, the lower 48, maybe another block. But right now it's not showing that, and neither is the GFS. But to have so much convection where it's building this in front And thank God all this is going to come together. The last thing we want to see is two start training together or worse. That is a lot of convection away from this low pressure. Now, it will slowly come together. You can see the same thing happening over here in the Eastern Pacific. You get another area of convection, but look how it's swallowing up into one. And that's more likely what we're going to see out of this. It's just a lot of convection going on right now. And this is right over the loop current. So all this is going to rapid intensify. It's waiting to intensify. Thank you for your time, everybody. Thank you so much for helping me get the word out to other people so they know what is going on with the storm system. May God bless you all and keep you all safe from this system. Please check on your neighbors. Make sure they are under the right state of mind of what is going on. Going to a shelter or evacuating, please. Remember, all the links are in the description below this video. Now, before I go for this morning, 2 Corinthians 4:8-10. We are troubled on every side, yet not distressed. We are perplexed, but not in despair. Persecuted, but not forsaken. Cast down, but not destroyed. Always bearing about in the body the dying of the Lord Jesus, that the life also of Jesus might be made manifest in our body. Amen. I know everyone is going through a lot right now. Just slow down, take a breath, and remember to be thankful. All the anxiety you're feeling, if you just slow down for a second, and just be thankful for what you have. Thankful for who you have near you. Just be thankful. Because once you are thankful and you humble yourself a little bit, everything becomes clear, the anxiety goes away, and you know what you must do. So just calm down and just be thankful. Remember, all glory goes to God, our Father in heaven, Yahweh, and He will keep you safe every single day of your life and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Slow down, be thankful, then do what you want to do. Make sure you're safe. Please check on your neighbors. I will see you this afternoon for the update.